I want to say categorically that is total
rubbish.
What do you need?
The other one I saw that if you don't have a HUDUMA number, you can't send money to Kenya. Again, I say, those who are wave and wherever when you're sending money, is there a place it shows insert your HUDUMA number? The only thing that could prevent you from sending money is the balance in your. Then another one last week, I think the most ridiculous one.
Which one?
That you don't be around to marry if you don't have a marriage. And it became such a heat topic. You mean I can't get married? I have a wedding next week. What am I going to do?
Oh my.
You know?
So are you going to advertise that on your website? Probably clarify all this.
The requirements are there. Just look at the website. The requirements are there. You know, we can't say you go by exclusion. What is authorized is there. If everything else which is not authorized, it's not applicable. Yeah, it's not applicable. Yeah. So good. So, you know, banks are very generous. Yeah? Now that CBA has given us a chance to spend all their money. I'm encouraging you to
eat,
drink, and get married.
Be married. Yes.
Kenyans have over 10 of them into one. But if you have one HUDUMA number, you don't need to carry your driving license because your driving license will be in the HUDUMA number. Your birth certificate will be there. Your NSSF will be there. Your NHIF will be there. Your driving license will be there. Your income tax will be there. Your PIN number will be there. So you only need that HUDUMA card when it's available. Wherever you go, if it's a driving license, you show it and all the particulars are there. So that's the whole purpose. And it's voluntary, not compulsory.
Okay. Now they have a deadline.
The mass registration has a deadline. Yeah. From there, then you have to go now to a HUDUMA center.
Now the question is,
At the moment, we are doing it because now we want to give those people a chance to come to them. So we are doing the embassies and consulates. Those are the structures we have. But we have made appeals and said, look, USA is a continent, not a country. And I give them a good example. From Nairobi to Bombay in 6 hours. From East Coast,
6 hours.
But you are in the same country. So I tell them, look, take the route from Bombay. Look at the number of countries that you cross. Kenya, Somalia, Ethiopia, Yemen. You know, all those countries over there. So hopefully, we're going to be allowed to go, to be authorized to go around. Now, before I sit down, two things I want to move from your mind. I saw it in the social media.